My name is Andrew Kennedy. My great-grandfather was a Native chief here in Alaska, and I wondered, what did my ancestors do to entertain themselves without video games? How did they survive without Nintendo? I decided to find out. My first step was to talk to Native game expert Eliza Jones. I asked her, did my ancestors get bored without video games?
I don't think we had a word for bored, because there was no such thing. When we were children, and kids never said, I'm bored, because they always created ways to be active. All the games that they played was preparing them for making a living. They had to be active, they had to learn how to trap, and they had to learn how to hunt. And all these games that they played is preparing them for life. So, no, a video game would not have done it. Because for one thing, they need physical activities.
After my interview, I traveled to Howard Luke's camp, where I heard kids were practicing old school Native games.
The games themselves are traditional games of different types of sports that go way back for exercise and endurance and to gain strength. And they were originated in the villages to, you know, occupy time and train for hunting and fishing and games of fun and excitement.
Games to show your do your physical and your mental capability in the wilderness. So, such as the seal hop is to like hop to ice, and yeah.
But if they did have video games back in the day, I bet they would have looked like this. What have I learned from my journey? That we must remember our past in order to stay in touch with our native roots. But video games are still awesome. Baby, 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 I'm awfully crazy. I'm Ciroc, off a throne, shit, whatever's tasty.